Plants are morphologically distinct with roots, stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. What is the function of roots? The roots are absorb the water and minerals from the soil and given to shoot of or stem of the plant. The water is absorbed by the root and entered into the xylem in the vascular bundles that is transmitted to the all the parts of the plant body. How it's happened? That is the question. And the plant is depends for its food. It means photosynthesis. The photosynthesis happened at leaves. It means the organic molecules are formed at the leaves. From at leaves, the formed organic molecules are being transported into every part of the plant. How it's happened? You see, from leaves to stem, leaves to root, leaves to tip of the stem, leaves to tip of the root, how the nutrients, mineral nutrients are transmitted. So, for these questions, the answer is found in transport in plants. The transport in plants basically say the movements of water as well as solutes from roots to other parts, other parts to tip of the places. And here basically we are seeing the movement, solute movements or water movement. How? The movement or transport, the transport in plants that may be two types. One is unidirectional, unidirectional. Another one is multidirectional, multidirectional. How it's? You see here unidirectional, unidirectional means, for example, you take xylem. In the xylem, the water and minerals strictly transmitted, by unidirection, unidirection. So, this is the plant structure. The plant is absorb the water, minerals. So, this is the roots. So, the roots are absorb the water. Water is available in the soil. The available water is capillary water. The capillary water is absorbed by the root heads. And the water is entered into the xylem of vascular bundles. Xylem of vascular bundles. From here to, it is transmitted to remaining parts of the plant. In what side it transmitted? Upwards. It means from downwards to the upwards, the water movement is being taken. The water movement has been taken. So, that always unidirectional, unidirectional. From where the water has been transported, the water is absorbed by the roots. From the roots, the water is transported to the tip of the stem also by xylem. Okay. So, simply I said as the water movement present in the xylem, that is unidirectional. But transportation is multidirectional. What is a multidirectional transportation? Organic and mineral substances. Organic and mineral substances. Where they are produced? They are produced at leaves. leaves, because the leaf is the site of the photosynthesis. At the leaves, the organic molecules are produced, the minerals are produced. Okay, so the produced organic materials are transported to vascular bundle part, that is phloem. So that means the phenomena is called translocation. It means the organic molecules which are formed at the leaves, they are translocated into the all the part of the plant body. Sometimes they are stored at roots also. For example, you take the tuberous plants. At the tuberous plants, the tubers are formed at roots. The roots are termed as tuberous roots. Here the food is stored. It means from leaves to the formed food is transmitted into roots. Sometimes from its stored organs, the stored food is reutilized. Reutilized means that also re-entered into the stem, sometimes into leaves. It means the direction may be again opposite. So you see here, one direction is for storage, another direction is for reuse. It means multiple directions for transportation. So multi-directional transportation is taken for organic and mineral substances. How it is done means, it is done by phloem. Phloem. Both phloem and xylem are present in vascular bundles. These are responsible for the transportation of water, minerals as well as organic substances. But the water movements in the plant, it is explained in many phenomena.